guys. How's it going, everyone? This is Daniel Lopez. You know, you see me with Lisa and Blue Island Gage. And we're here for a very special session of information, a little exciting update to our RN program. I have Dr. Annabelle Palomo, the director of the school. And I just want to ask her a few questions. We want to be able to provide a little bit of information for the students that are out there who are very interested. We've got a lot of phone calls, a lot of emails, a lot of Facebook, and of course it's an exciting opportunity. So maybe if you could just kind of, you know, start us out with a little bit about where we stand right now on our RN program.
Okay, like Danny said, we have been getting a lot of phone calls, huh?
Right.
Calling, asking, and I know that a lot of people are anxious for this program. Just a little bit, an update. It is a longer process because it is our first associate's program. We've worked with just certificate-based programs. So pretty much we can anticipate a start date for the fall. This fall we should be getting our ducks all in line. And the reason it's taken us maybe a little longer is that we're making sure that we have our systems in place for our students. What's our motto?
We're not successful until our students are successful.
Exactly. So we want to make sure that whoever enters our program takes NCLEX and becomes certified as an RN. So that's been a little bit of our holdup, but by this fall we should have our first cohort starting.
Okay, awesome. So obviously we're here in our new building right now because we're trying to bring you some of this new information from where a lot of you are going to be seeing it from when you start. You know, we've had lots of different questions about this and that about the program. Of course, you talked about hopefully when we'll be starting it. So what's roughly the length of the program that we're looking at right now?
Like any associate's program, it will be a two-year program. The only difference here, we do have it as a standalone ADM program. Or we can have it as a transition program. So some of our students have come through our doors for the vocational nursing program. They can actually transition from a vocational nursing program into the ADM program and get certified there.
Okay, now, and you of course mentioned associate's degree. We know this
yes.
is an associate's degree program.
Yes.
Maybe if you want to just remind everyone that, you know, we're RGB College, we are just like any other college. Tell them that, you know, what you get with us with this program, kind of describe maybe how that compares.
Okay, Danny did share with me, we are a college. We're accredited by the Higher Education Coordinating Board.
Right.
So this is like any other college as far as certification. So when you do get your certification from your diploma, you are able to transfer it to other colleges, and we're again regulated by the Texas Board of Nursing. As a matter of fact, even this year I predict we will be the highest scoring vocational nursing school. We right now we have almost 100% passing as far as our vocational nursing program. So the success we've had in our vocational nursing program, we want to transfer that into the ADM program. So pretty much if you do attend RGB College, it's like any other college.
Awesome, of course. And we're very proud of our NCLEX scores, our passing rate. And of course that, you know, is something that we always speak to others about on your behalf, but you know, it really translates in, you know, each day in, day out that our instructors spend,
yes.
right? And so we want to take that same level of commitment from our LVM program, put that into our RN program, right?
Exactly. We do have our DO1 in place for the ADM program right now. I often tell the teachers that it's what happens in the classroom that makes us successful. So just like Danny just mentioned, as far as our success with the vocational nursing program, we want to make sure those same systems that we've had in place for 9 years, because we've been in existence with the vocational nursing program for 9 years now, to make sure we transfer that into the ADN program.
And, you know, some students are probably wondering whether or not financial aid is involved in this process.
Yes, financial aid will be available for that program also.
Awesome, okay. So what we're seeing is that, you know, right down, not too long, right down the pipeline, we're going to see our RN program kick in. You know, we're working out the last little bit, bits here and there. But just like any other school, right, we're going to get you an associate's degree.
Yes.
You guys are going to put in 2 years of awesome hard work, and when it's all said and done, you're going to be RNs, right?
Yes, we are. And we are looking forward to a lot more other programs as far as associate's programs coming into RGB College. We want to make sure that we provide those opportunities for students in our community. So we're fully committed to that. Some of our programs will be starting to become associate's programs, such as our MA and our PT program. So we are working towards making sure that we provide quality education for our community. That's
our goal. That you mentioned some of the other programs, some of our students have called and asked us, like, will any of the other things they've done before, like medical assistant, will that apply towards the RN?
Good question. Right now, no. We are in the process of just getting approved for the EMT program, the beginner, the intermediate, and the advanced.
Awesome.
After you've had that program for 2 years, it's a 2-year wait. You can then offer the paramedic. I am looking into doing a EMT transfer into the ADN program type of certification through our either a weekend or a hybrid program. We've had a lot of EMT students who are now VN students. So pretty much we are looking into that program transferring into the ADN program.
Okay, that's great news. Now you said, you mentioned the hybrid program, right?
Yes.
Will an RN have the hybrid when we started?
Oh, good question. And I know a lot of, you know, we are happy that we can provide the hybrid program because a lot of students have to work and attend school. I was one of those students while working on my doctorate. Right now, we need to make sure we get our systems totally in place before we go that route. Do I foresee it in the future? Yes. If we are successful during our day program, there's no reason why we can't offer it as far as the hybrid.
Okay, that's a lot of great information, Doc. Let's see, let's finish them off with one thing. Right now, if I'm a student, I want to pursue the RN path. I'm not really sure where to go. Of course, you're getting a lot of great information now, but what would we have the students do right now? Help them start, you know, planning ahead. Like, what can they do? They call us, put them on a wait list.
Well, if anything, we do have a wait list, and it's a long one. So that's kind of what we're trying to do is to get this going because we want to provide that for our community. If anything, start getting educated. You know, just do it. That's our motto, right? Got to get started. That tomorrow never comes. So get into our vocational nursing program because more than anything, we've known you as a student. If you're successful through our vocational nursing program, I know you're going to be successful through the ADN program. The first cohort that the board does gives you about 40 students. We have a long wait list and we know some of those students. So does that help? Yes, because we know what type of students and whether or not they're committed. So if anything, I would recommend to get started. Get started, come in our doors, get into our vocational nursing program if you don't have that under your belt, so that way when you are ready to transfer, that you're fully already equipped with your vocational nursing certification.
Awesome. And guys, if you're looking to get started and you're not currently an LVN, then you're going to need a little bit of experience under your belt as well. So you may want to talk to us, call admissions, call school, about how you go about doing that, whether you take the medical assistant route or the certified nurse aid. But either way, we're building a future for you guys, a long-term plan that's going to make amazing nurses here in the Valley. And I don't know, Doc, if you have anything else to add?
Well, nothing, just that we're excited. Hopefully, we're opening our doors in August. We'll have a full-blown open house. We have a facility that is going to be conducive to learning. We've been waiting for that. We have a learning center. We're going to have a computer lab. We're going to have a snack bar. We're going to have areas where students get to study. So as a staff, we're really, really looking forward to that. And hopefully, we'll have our different students coming in our doors.
Wonderful. Well, Dr. Thank you for your time.
You're welcome.
And a lot of people are going to really appreciate the information. And guys, look, just keep up with us on Facebook. Keep up with us on Instagram, social media. We got a lot of really cool things coming soon that we're going to be doing to help integrate us more, help us stay in touch with you. And before you know it, we'll be here in this building and we'll be shooting live videos about the grand opening. All right, guys, so keep it up. All the hard work you guys do, and just all I can say is, what, we're not successful?
Until our students are successful.
Thank you, guys.